This is going to be a reading for the sign of Libra. So what you guys can possibly expect for the next, let's take 10 to 12 days, okay? So one card for what's happening currently in your life. I hope you guys are doing well. You know, we are almost at the last phase of Mercury retrograde, and it's getting over. The last part of it kind of kicked my butt a bit, okay? That's why I wasn't doing readings. Wasn't in the right energy to be doing readings. So, you know, I kept my space. So, yeah. So, currently with the World card, many of you guys are going through a cycle. Okay, some of you could be ending a cycle. Some of you could be starting a new cycle. Okay, take what resonates. With Four of Cups, I feel like if you are a part of a relationship, situationship, partnership, whatever, marriage, that is not going anywhere and you are tired of it, you feel like things are not going to get you know, change for the better, or things are not getting better between the two of you, so many of you might decide to end it or walk away or stay away or keep it you know, like end it. You are not going to want to fix it, okay? For some of you, after dropping someone, you are starting a new connection, okay? So take what resonates. Since I talk to a lot of people here, you know, everyone has a different story. With Four of Wands, some of you could be in a relationship in the month of November, okay? I see that as a possibility. Some of you could be going out to meet your people, your partners, your, you know, maybe some of you live in a long distance relationship, so you have to travel in order to see your partner. But for many of you, I see you ending your relationship, you, not your partner, but you wanting to end very much, you know, like a gone situation, like something that is not getting better, something that is not having any sort of future. You know, it's pretty much dead, it's stuck. Okay, top card we have here is Princess of Swords in the reverse. So you guys could not be talking, or there is no communication, okay? And you are so tired and so done with it that you might decide to end it, okay? So let's start with Seven of Cups and the Lovers card. Many of you guys will have choices this coming month. I see you being in good energy overall. Yes, right now you might not be in a good space, you know, give it few more days. After the 6th of November, I see the energy changing for the better, okay? Top card with Three of Swords. Many of you guys are in separation, okay? If it's not separation and you never had a partner, then many of you guys are finally decided to let go of the past completely in order to move forward. You cannot move forward unless you're willing to let go of the past. You know, I have many clients who tell me every day that they have moved on. I mean, who are you fooling, man? I mean, I know your story. I know what you have been through. You know, you say that you are moving on, but you are not. You know, you are still stuck to the past person. You're still waiting for the past person to see what they are doing. You know, so I still feel until and unless you completely let go of the idea, you do not care what happened to the past person, or what the past person intentions are towards you, or what they are wanting to do next. You know, until and unless you are in that phase, you cannot move on. If you are still bothered about what he's doing or what she's doing, whether she's coming back, whether she's fooling you, whether she's cheating you, it doesn't matter. If you do not want them, it does not matter who they are doing or how many people they are doing it with. Okay, what matters is you move on. What matters is yourself, not them. If you meant it so much to them, they would have worked it with you. They would have put in efforts. They would have seen to it that, you know, you are taken care of. But no, you are still waiting on them. You are watching terror for them, and they are doing someone else. You know, you got to understand what you are worth. If you still in that mentality that no matter what happens to me or what happens in this connection, I still want them. I do not know what to say. You know, you need to be strong enough. If you are in that mentality, no one can help you. Trust me on that. Okay, so let's see what's coming up for you guys for the next few days. Let's take the next 2 weeks. Okay, we have King of Wands. Just like I told you, I see you being in good energy in the coming days. Okay, right now you might be in the phase that you are in at crossroads, wondering what you should do and whether you should, you know, possibly take time away or whether you should stay open for dating and meeting new people. Okay, with Four of Cups right now, I see you being in a bit jumbled energy, a bit little off track, feeling low. Okay, so I see you have been a bit low emotionally as well. Some of you could be having some depressing thoughts, but it's okay. You know, the time is such that it's fine. It's gonna pass. Okay, so let's see one card for what's coming up for you in terms of soulmate relationships. Okay, with Three of Swords, Princess of Pentacles, and Six of Cups. Okay, so with Three of Swords, I feel like for some of you, someone who broke your heart is trying to come back. They are going to message you and possibly going to try to return. Okay, this person has been someone from your past. It has to be someone from your past. It is not a new person. Okay, in the past, I see them having Seven of Wands. So the distance, possibly distance themselves or pushed you away, but right now with Three of Swords, they are feeling this heartbreak. With Princess of Pentacles, that is Page of Pentacles, they are wanting to communicate with you or start something with you, a very small offer, very, very small offer. With Six of Cups, what's on their mind? They are wanting to return. Okay, here we have the other two cards, Princess of Pentacles and Three of Swords. So let's see what they have in mind. Okay, one card for how are they viewing you now as a person? One card. Okay. With the Devil card, they cannot let go of you. They are still having your thoughts. They cannot move on from you. With Ten of Pentacles, maybe for some of you in the past, they chose finances or their family over you. Take what resonates. If it's a working person, they chose their career, their finances. If it's a family person who had a family, married, unmarried, whatever, they chose their family. But right now, I very much see them wanting to come forward. Okay, give me one more card as to how they view you as a soulmate. One card for how they view you as a soulmate. In the past, they could have thought that you were toxic. Trust me on this. Okay, with the Devil card. In terms of soulmate, you know, your person is not in a very open situation where they could come and meet you. Okay, your person has self-doubt. One, they could be restricted by their home environment. Maybe they are married or they are in a relationship or something is happening. Maybe it's a long-distance relationship, but they feel like they are tired and they cannot have that free jump towards you or that leap, take that leap of faith towards you. In terms of soulmates, they still feel like there are many roadblocks in between the two of you. Okay, top card we have is Six of Swords. So they could feel that you finally, after staying stuck on them, you are trying to move on. Okay, they may feel that you are not wanting to reach out. Okay, they may feel that you are finally wanting to break free. Okay, with Strength card, you are using all your strength necessary to move forward and not come towards them. With Princess of Swords, they may feel that you do stalk them, but majorly you're focused on moving on. Okay, give one card for how are they thinking of you now? How are they thinking of you now? With Four of Cups, they are very miserable without you. Okay, yes, they are trying to possibly ghost you, but they are still very miserable without you. They cannot let go of you. Even if they had other options, they could not walk away from you. I feel for many of you in the past, your person tried to ghost you or tried to push you away or tried to pretend that they have many options which are much better than you. Okay, and that kind of triggered you into wanting to stay away from them. Okay, take what resonates. Okay. With Nine of Wands in the reverse, how they're thinking of you, they are possibly wanting to open up now. Okay, give me one more card as to how they're possibly thinking of you, Libra. These are general readings, okay, so they may or may not resonate with you. If they do, consider hitting the like button. If they don't, choose another reading by any other reader on YouTube or wherever. Okay, with Ten of Swords and Seven of Cups, they very much know that they have hurt you. Okay, they very much know that they have hurt you. They could have possibly broken ties with you in the past, and they chose to stay away from you. They chose to possibly stay open to other options. Okay, top card we have trust me on this, they are very much stalking you. Okay, but the problem is they have hurt you in the past, and thanks to their options, things kind of got more worse. Okay, they always made you believe that they have much better options than you, and it killed your self-respect. It killed your confidence. It possibly did more damage to you than them. Okay, so yes, in terms of Four of Wands, I believe for many of you, in the past, your person could have been a bit sneaky. They were trying to find ways into another relationship or into another connection, or they were trying to make a move towards a more stable relationship. If you guys could not really have a stable connection, you and them, you know, no matter how much efforts you put in, no matter how much time you give the connection, you guys could never really commit to each other, then I believe for those people, your person tried to move on. Okay, and you as well tried to move on. You both were trying to move on in the month of October, late part. Okay, so one card for their intentions towards you now. Just a second. Sorry. So here we go. Their intentions towards you now. What are their intentions towards you now? Okay, with Ten of Pentacles and Seven of Pentacles, I definitely feel like they are wanting to invest. Okay, possibly spend more time and possibly see where things go with you. Ten of Pentacles is a very stable card to get, but I believe their main intention is to possibly stay invested into you. Bottom card we have is Three of Swords. So trust me, in the past, they very much broke your heart. They pushed you away. They saw to it that you move on. If you were not moving on from them, they saw to it that they push you away in their own fucking ways. Okay, so one more card. So what are they wanting to do towards you now in terms of action, please? One card for that. Okay, I also feel like currently they are going to stay at a distance. Currently, I still see them ghosting you. In terms of action, they are not very much intentionally coming forward. They will come forward, but at their own time. As of now, they are possibly in that hermit phase. In the past, they could have tried to trigger you, but they never took that that initiative to come forward. Okay, but they did trigger you. Top card, we have Seven of Swords. So they are still not coming forward and opening up about their emotions. I still see mind games going on, darling. I still very much see mind games going on. Okay? And this person is still not wanting to be 100% honest with you. Okay? Give one card for their current feelings towards you. Their current feelings towards you, please. Okay, with Six of Pentacles, this person wants to bring in balance. Now, usually Six of Pentacles is a card where things are one-sided, but usually when it's this deck, I see it, your person wanting to balance things out with you. Almost like a Lover's card or Two of Cups, where this person is wanting to bring in balance. Okay, the scales are at equal, position. So I very much feel that right now, your person with Queen of Pentacles and Six of Pentacles is possibly trying to, change things. Like possibly make things better for the two of you. Okay, one card for how do they feel about you now? Okay, we had probably have a card with Four of Pentacles. They are still not opening up. You know, Pentacles are not about someone opening up emotionally to you. Yeah, they are possessive about you. They cannot see you moving on, or they cannot see you with someone else. But it's not a very romantic card to get. Pentacles are never romantic. You know, so Earth signs, man, come on. Okay, so I do feel that your person is wanting to bring in balance, but not a very romantic month ahead. Okay, still wanting to hold on to you, give in to you, but not really say much, do much, or make you feel anything at all. Okay, so what do they truly have for you? One card, what do they truly have for you? Libra, soulmates truly have for Libra in terms of feelings, passion. With Knight of Wands, your person is very much wanting to come forward. I see more passion than emotions, okay? I'll be honest with you. In the past, your person was confused. They were not wanting to open up to their feelings. They were wanting to stay away from their own feelings. Crazy shit, right? In the past, they also tried to friend zone you and they possibly distance from you. But right now, I see them coming forward. With Knight of Wands, I see them very much charging forward. But Knight of Wands is not a very trusted card to get, but yes, they're going to come forward. With Two of Cups, I mean, that clarifies the situation that they're wanting to come forward in order to have something with you. Long term, short term, that's up to you. That's up to how you play. But I see them opening up, but not in a very romantic way. But yes, I see them much more open to you in terms of a connection. Okay, so take what resonates. So where is this connection going forward for Libra for the next 10 to 12 days? Trust me when I say this, I still see some ghosting going on. Okay, so the first few days, let's take up till the 6th of November. Do not expect much. I'll be very honest with you. The rest stuff, I do see them coming back for a second chance. Okay, like around maybe the 7th or the 8th. Okay, but I still do not see you completely being open to them. Okay, I still see you wanting to be emotionally independent and possibly stay focused on you. Okay, I feel you are going to reject them this time. I do not know why I'm getting that. Trust me on that. With Three of Swords, you're very much heartbroken. You are not very happy with what this person has made you go through. With Four of Swords, you're focused more on healing than anything else. Okay? And with the Hermit card, you're trying to stay focused on your life and find ways in order to fix your life. Okay? So what are they wanting from you currently? What are they wanting from you currently? I'm also going to be doing daily readings now on I'll be posting a link on Instagram story that is Libra Vibes Only. So please go on my story, follow my ch channel on Libra Vibes Only, and you could go and check my story tomorrow or day after. I'll be posting regular readings now, 24 hours, 48 hours. It's going to be on YouTube, but the link is going to be on Instagram. Okay, so let's do it more regularly since your case is so fucked up. Okay. We have a card. This person wants you to open up. This person wants you to possibly tell them that you still want them. Okay, they want that assurance that you still want them. Okay, bottom card is the Magician card. Top card is the Tower. They are very much freaked out that you're moving on. Okay, so let's take love messages from your person. What is your person wanting to say to you that they haven't said so far? Let me take a shuffle and we are good to go. Okay. Yes, I accept I can't express my feelings. You know, this has been going on for the longest time. Okay, but I do love you. I push you away because you deserve better. Second card. I thought of explaining myself, but it scares me. I do not know how to act. Okay, I thought of explaining myself. Okay, but I do not know how to act. Okay, so that's the last card. Okay, I'll take one bonus card. What is Libra want? What should Libra know about their partner? What are they up to? Universe, if you could get one card based on that, please. you will hear from me soon. So I feel that your person will possibly reach out to you, but do not expect fast communication. Okay, I'll be very honest with you. Up till the 5th, you cannot expect much from this person. Okay, they are very much possibly still pushing you off. Okay, my life and is and will be empty without you. Okay, so this is the last card, so that's going to be the title of the story. Okay, so all those who are wanting to reach out to me for personal readings, please book it within the next 3 days. Okay, I won't take more than I'll possibly see if I could manage, but I'm still trying to get back to you within 7 days after booking. But I can still take up to 7 to 10 days. Okay, so if you want a personal reading from me, go to my website, check out the readings, reach out to me on DM, Instagram, or my WhatsApp, or possibly even email. We have the PayPal link there. Pay and do reach out. Okay, do not call without having to book anything. I'm not wanting to talk to people, as a friendship, on a very friendship basis. So only if you're interested in a personal reading, do reach out. Okay, I'm not going to entertain nonsense. Okay, so yeah. So thank you so much for coming in, and see you soon, guys. And do reach out on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram on Libra Vibes Only. I'll be posting a lot more general readings, a lot more Libra daily readings, 24 hours, 48 hours, 72 hours, Libra in separation as well. But you have to follow, and you'll have to check the story for the link. Okay, so yeah, see you soon, guys. Cheers.